Good evening. Thank you for joining us tonight at the beautiful Richard Root Library in Kentwood. We're here tonight to talk about government matters, and what matters is the commission race going on for the city of Kentwood. We have a couple of candidates here tonight that want to tell you what they think on the issues. And I'll now introduce our moderator from the, of our board of directors, Kathey Batey. Kathy.
Thank you very much for joining us this evening. I realize it's a beautiful night out there and there are many other places that you could be, but this is important, that we are involved politically under local government, because local government really runs the world. So it's important that you're here. I appreciate that you're here. The chamber appreciates that you're here. Thank you to Kentwood Library for allowing us to be in this beautiful building. We would like to begin by stating the Pledge of Allegiance, so if you would please join me. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Good evening, gentlemen, and thank you for joining us tonight. We have some questions that we would like to pose to you. We also would like any audience member who does have a question. We do have some cards. If you'd raise your hand, slip your hand up, Bob will bring a card to you, and then I will pose that question to our candidate. So please feel free at any time. He'll be watching for that. I did see a hand back there, Bob, so we will go ahead and get started. We are going to begin with a two-minute opening. We did flip a coin, and Steve Redmond, our first candidate, our incumbent this evening, is going to start with a two-minute introduction, telling us about yourself and why it is that we should vote for Steve Redmond for city commissioner.
Great. Thank you, Kathy, and thank everyone for coming out tonight for this forum. I was appointed to the position of commissioner-at-large back in March. And when I was appointed to that position, I told the city commissioners then that one of the things I brought to the table in terms of qualification was experienced leadership. And I have a big belief in public service. And my belief in public service is evidenced by my service for the city of Kentwood. I started out working with Kentwood Public Schools as a volunteer, worked very hard on the committee to redistrict elementary students when the new elementary school was built, when I first moved here. After that, I was appointed to the Kentwood Park and Recs Board. After that, I also worked on the Arts Advisory Council for the city of Kentwood. We started the concerts, the summer series that happened here in the summer at the Kentwood Library. And then finally, the Planning Commission. So through all that experience, I was able to work with some real good people and learn a lot of things about public service and service for the people of Kentwood. It's those qualifications that I bring to the seat that allow me, I think, to make good decisions. One of the things that I learned about decision making in public service is that you have to measure the impacts, the financial impacts, the impacts on safety, the impacts on citizens. And you have to listen to other citizens, you have to listen to residents, you have to listen to your fellow board members, you have to form coalitions with people in order to make good things happen for the city. So all that experience and all those things I've learned is what I bring to the table. And I think that's a reason that my experienced leadership in these positions and experience service is why I think people of Kentwood should vote to keep me, retain me as city commissioner at large.
Thank you. Our next candidate, Thomas Webb, you have 2 minutes, please.
Well, thank you. Good evening, everybody. I want to start by thanking the Wyoming Kentwood Chamber of Commerce and Bob O'Callaghan and Kathey Batey for this event. It's a great opportunity for the public to gain awareness. I am Thomas Webb, and I want to be the candidate you choose for the Kentwood City Commission. I'm here because I want a government that works more efficiently and effectively for the businesses and families of Kentwood. I don't think the city should spend our hard-earned tax dollars just because it's in the budget. Our budgets at home are strict and stringent, and when we have leftovers, we take that money and pay off our debt or put into savings for future needs and retirement. Our city needs to be re-examine our budget very carefully. I see time and time again where things are replaced because it was budgeted for. When it was clearly not a need, it seemed more like a want. When the city replaces assets, we need to examine carefully the usefulness of the existing asset, existing costs for upkeep, and lifespan against the replacement asset, and see if the costs work. As a business owner, I'm very aware of how to keep an enterprise sustainable. The needs of a city are very similar to that of a business. The most important commonality between successful businesses and cities are the fact that they're both responsible to keep the customers' services and happy, quality and service. I mean, our city needs to provide top-notch services, including our wonderful police and fire departments, along with plowing, parks, and many more, too many to list. If our city can reduce spending by prolonging the life of assets and being wise with every purchase, we can really focus on the needs versus wants. We can either provide more services or reduce property taxes of our hardworking taxpayers of Kentwood. And for those reasons and many more, I believe that I'm the right candidate for the job.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I will go over here to Stephen Redman and ask his question, and you will have 2 minutes to respond to it. Oh, I'm sorry, 90 seconds. We'll do 90 seconds as a response, and then I'll go over to Thomas Webb. Sorry, change of the rules midstream. What is it that you offer to this team of people that does not currently exist on the commissioner board?
I'm sorry, what was that?
What do you offer to this team of people that does not currently exist on the commissioner board?
What I offer to the team of people who are on the commission right now? Mm-hmm.
What do you, since you're an incumbent, that's kind of an awkward question. What do you offer to the team of people that you work with?
Oh, okay, on the city commission?
Mm-hmm.
What I've, I have about, now it's about 22 years experience working with the Michigan Department of Transportation. In the capacity of that job, I work with local governments. I've worked with local governments throughout the state of Michigan. In the last 12 or 13 years, I've worked mainly with local governments throughout West Michigan. Through that experience, I learned the different issues that face local governments, and I deal with them on a daily basis. Not only infrastructure type issues, but other things like public transit, issues that how communities can improve themselves through the use of downtown development projects, through streetscapes, that kind of thing. And I've learned a lot by working with local governments and have a good feel for the different issues that local governments face through all that experience. Beyond that, what I offer is that I have a degree in public policy from Michigan State University. I've been working in public policy since I graduated from college. It's something I'm real familiar with. Creating policies and understanding how they impact a whole community is something I'm real familiar with through study and through experience. So I think that's one of the things I offer to the team on the City Commission, that I can give that perspective and that knowledge that allows allows input into good decision making by the Commission as a whole.
Thank you. I will move over to Candidate Webb as I lose my mic here. I'll move over to Candidate Webb and ask this question. What do you offer to this team of people that does not currently exist on the commission board?
Well, I find that I am a very successful business owner. I've owned businesses in technology, construction, purchasing, logistics, and I find that that has given me an incredibly wide spectrum of knowledge where when there's questions asked, I can actually have some answers for it. I also will be able to find a way to ask questions that maybe people are not thinking about what to ask. I am a very social person. I am always out talking to the public and discussing with them what their feelings are about things. And I will be always on top of bringing that information back to the City Commission and trying to solve the problems of what the citizens of Kentwood find as issues.
Thank you. I'm not sure I'm heard elsewhere, but you folks can hear me, so that's what counts. Please tell us, what is your financial background?
My financial background is in budgeting, public finance for infrastructure projects. Also, the use of government grants, both community development block grants that are used by communities to address problems in low-income areas. also that, you know, some other things that I've been involved in throughout my career, labor relations and understanding business budgets and how that all comes into healthcare costs, which is something that's real valuable here, as that is a constantly changing field we have to deal with our employees. I have experience in that. So, you know, in a nutshell, it's public finance, but with some human resource benefit finance background as well.
Thank you. Thomas Webb, could you please tell us what is your financial background?
Well, as I said before, I'm a business owner. I've always have been a business owner. I've owned my own businesses since 1996. Within that, I have had companies that have had employees from 5 to 50, and we've had multiple departments of every kind, shape, size, and I've had to oversee each and every type and make sure that we're budgeted properly. And you know, when I had businesses overseas, I had to work with multiple companies and budget for large projects. You know, I have been working in finance my entire life, essentially. It's been my job. You know, I work to save every single dollar I can. When I work on every single project, my customers come to me because they have the expectation and the knowledge that I am going to treat every project with the utmost care and make sure that the dollars that are spent like they're my own. So in the end, they have the most efficient project and a quality project.
Thank you. City Commissioner Redmond, can you tell us, is there clear, transparent communication from the City of Kentwood to the constituents?
I believe there is. One of the things I did when I prepared to get to become to enter my name in the City Commission appointment process is I was able to go on the website and look at a number of documents about the budget, about clerk duties, about every department has documents out there now that you can find out a whole lot about with the city of what's going on. Also, it's still the reliable publicizing information that's important. We as a city cannot, before we go and issue a bond, we have to have a notice of the intent to get a bond, and that has to be published. And we also have the notice that we are going to purchase the bond. It's a two-step process that allows people, residents, if they want to start a referendum on that bond if they're against that spending. I think those kind of tools are really needed and are transparent. They give people a picture of what we're doing. When we have our committee of the whole meetings, everything, there's called an e-packet. Everything that takes place at our committee of the whole meetings and city commission meetings are available online. So again, the use of social media that allows that transparency. We use our website as well for other areas. So yeah, I think the transparency is there. Can it be improved? It's going to have to be improved because with the...
Thank you. Yeah. We will give you other opportunity. Thomas Webb, is there clear, transparent communication from the City of Kentwood to the constituents?
I believe there is some communication. I believe there is definitely room for improvement. On a regular basis, I attend the City Commission meetings, and I am regularly, I bring my tablet, which has the e-packet that Mr. Redmond mentioned, and in there is not all the information that they are seeing. And this information is not private in any way that I shouldn't be allowed to see it, but it's information that's not available to me, unless I had requested it prior. Copies of the bids for things that they have. All I see in the end is that the staff has requested that we honor this bid or select this bid. As a citizen, I'd like to see all the bids that were submitted and be able to understand why the selection was made. That's not information that you can readily find online. You have to specifically request it, which could take a FOIA request or it could take time and energy that I don't think is necessarily needed. It should be available online. It is already in electronic form because it's been transferred between departments. So I believe there's definitely room for improvement on transparency.
Okay. Could you please, I'm going to start with you, Mr. Webb. Could you please give a specific example of where you would improve running the city of Kentwood?
Where I would improve running the city of Kentwood?
Yes.
Well, running the city of Kentwood is the mayor's job. The commission is in charge of directing the direction of the city. But as far as running the city's improvements,
well, within your capacity of
yeah.
City Commissioner.
I would like to see a yard waste facility for the city of Kentwood. Our neighboring cities have yard waste facilities. The city of Kentwood owns land and owns equipment that would be would make it possible to achieve that with not an incredible amount of effort. You know, the cities around us have that service, and their taxes are not very different than ours. You know, there are, we have a city now that has been around since 67. Many of the plants, the trees, the shrubs are all now overgrown to the point where people need to trim on a regular basis. When I first moved here several years ago, that was a large concern of mine. I purchased a piece of land and wanted to clear some. I had no place to put it. I was told I needed to truck it out of the city. I just did not find that was an appropriate method. You can hire a service, but having something local where you could take care of yourself is beneficial and economical for taxpayers.
Okay, thank you. Mr. Redman, could you give a specific example of where you would improve running the city of Kentwood within the capacity of a city commissioner?
One of the things I think, a step I've already taken to do that is my support of the establishment of the Kentwood Community Foundation. One of the things that I think is one of the better things about this city right now is some of the partnerships we have formed. We run an after-school program in partnership with Kentwood Public Schools. We have a partnership with the different cities around here to provide emergency services. Partnerships, facilitating those partnerships are key. Kentwood Community Foundation can help us do more of that. One of the things we're looking at is we've got a park system that has expanded. It's a beautiful park system, but we're going to have challenges with maintenance down the road. Kentwood Community Foundation could be a tool to help us address that. Facilitation of partnerships would be the one thing that I think we're already doing it, but I want to see it enhanced because that's what makes good government, makes good connections. And the other thing, too, is it helps leverage private dollars. A lot of the challenges that we face in parks and recreation and that type of thing, programs very important to the city. It's hard to continually, you go to the general fund for that. It's hard to go back for more millages to try and fund those things. So if we can establish more key partnerships and enhance those partnerships, that makes our government all the much better. I think we're already taking steps in that direction. And I think the Kentwood Community Foundation is one tool that's helping with that. And I'm very glad that I voted for it.
Good. Thank you very much. Tell us your proudest accomplishment, Candidate Webb.
My proudest accomplishment. Well, my proudest accomplishment has got to be many years of saving carefully so that our family could purchase the land that they really wanted. We worked really hard. We lived in an area that was not a great area. We saved our dollars as much as we could. We lived below our means so that we could pack money away so that when we could, we were able to move to somewhere, which is Kentwood, and purchase a piece of land that was able to give us what we wanted as our needs. We have land to furnish all of our desires as a family. You know, my two kids get to run around on acres of land. We have, you know, a big garden, and you know, the kids have their chores. It's everything we could ever want, and I'd have to say that was the best thing I could have ever my wife and I could have ever done.
Thank you, Candidate Redman. Your proudest accomplishment.
My proudest accomplishment. I have many in different areas for sure. I think in tonight's forum here, I'm going to talk a little bit about some of my proudest accomplishments have been in terms of public service. Going out and listening to those neighbors that don't think they're being listened to, that don't think they're getting the services that they need from the city, and being able to address that, one of my most proudest accomplishments, there's a little park near 44th and Division called Homemakers Park. We went out there, myself, director of, when I was on Parks and Recreation Board, I went out there with the Park and Rec director, one of the community police officers, and we had a discussion with those neighbors. And it was nice to have that discussion and learn from them why they wanted that lighting there, why they felt their safety was not being addressed because of the darkness around that park. So going and listening to those people and seeing the frustration in their voice, as they think that they weren't going to get any service, and the solutions we came out of that meeting with that allowed them to get the lighting, that allowed them to coordinate police protection and police enforcement at that park when they thought the services from the city had been forgotten, was one of my proudest accomplishments as a public servant. It was something that I was real happy to be involved in, and I it was something I'm very proud of.
Thank you. It was mentioned that your constituents, and Mr. Webb, you mentioned constituents as well, what you're hearing people say. What are you hearing people say? What are you hearing the constituents say when you talk to them on the street of their concerns for the city of Kentwood?
Who's first?
You are, Mr. Webb.
I've actually heard recently, I've heard a lot of people ask me about the yard waste, which I've already spoke about. I've also heard a lot of people mentioning that some of the roads that have been getting redone, they're not, they don't seem to be holding up as well as they'd like. Many people lately have come to me and said that Kentwood is not as beautiful as it once was. Down where I live, and I've also heard complaints from other people that when the city goes out and mows the lawns, they blow the grass right in the road and walk away, where I believe it's against an ordinance to do so. If we were to do that, we'd probably get a citation from the city for doing so. You know, I see a lot of times where the city properties, the grass is, you know, 2 feet tall, and where, you know, my next door neighbor, it gets to be 14 inches and they got a notice from the city. It's also very common that people wish to do things and they're told they can't. You know, down where I live, there are folks that wish to do some building of structures, and they refer to Kentwood as Kentwood because they are under the same restrictions as people with, say, an eighth of an acre when they have 10, 20, or 30 acres. So there's just room to allow citizens to get more needs satisfied that they have currently.
Okay, and Mr. Redmond, what are your constituents telling you when you were out on the street and campaigning and speaking to people?
By and large, the thing I hear most is that about grass not being cut, storage of vehicles in front yards, those type of things, and it's always nice to explain to them that, you know, a few years back we put more money into the budget and hired a specific inspector to address those. I don't think a lot of people are, some people just are not aware of that. When I explain it to them, you can see that they're looking, you know, like a light goes on. Maybe there's a vehicle here that I can use to try to address this. That, you know, my neighborhood, I keep up my lawn, I do my thing. Why can't the people around me do the same thing? Why do I have to look at a property that's just unkept? So that, surprisingly enough, that's the one that I hear the most. The other thing, though, I always hear about is again about police and fire, how important it is, and I always like to relate to people. You know, that message has been loud and clear to the government of Kentwood since 2010 when we passed that millage. When that millage passed the way it passed, it was a clear message that it's important that adequate, safe levels of police and fire protection are important to them. And that's why I'm a strong supporter of it, of police and fire. And that's why I've been able to get the endorsement of both the police and fire unions, because they realize the importance I place on that. And one of the reasons I place that kind of importance is based on the comments I get from my door knocking and meeting with people in the community.
Thank you. I'll go to you again, Mr. Redmond. Speak to your concerns for the safety of our community. Do you see any areas where we are not addressing or that need to be addressed in the safety of the community?
The one thing that I will say is that, this is going to be interesting to say, as my full-time job with the Michigan Department of Transportation, One of the things that I see is that the roads and the fixes for the roads, without an increase in funding from the state level, it's very hard to keep up with the transportation infrastructure. We're just finishing a great project on 52nd Street, but that project probably could have been done 3 or 4 years ago. But there's such a fight and lack of funds that these kind of street conditions are occurring. That is one thing in terms of safety of roads. I think there's still some roads within our city that we need to take a look from an engineering standpoint, how we can improve them. So they're just more efficient, more effective, and better transportation. It's better transportation infrastructure for our residents. So that's an area that I'm worried about. I worry about it not just here, but I worry about it on a state level too, within my day job and the challenges we have there. So that's the one thing that comes to mind. That's it. Infrastructure is certainly important to our city, and that's something that I always want to keep an eye on and maintain, it's something that our citizens can gain and benefit from.
Thank you. Mr. Webb, the safety, do you have any concerns for the safety in our community?
Well, we don't have an incredible amount of potholes around, so driving safety isn't that much of a concern. But, like I said before, the roads, there are areas where they're starting to get smaller sections that are having problems. Wing Avenue, which is right over here off of 52nd Street, going south of 60th Street, every day I have somebody tell me how they'd like to ride their bicycle down there to get to the trail, and it is incredibly unsafe. I mean, I drive down that every single day, and there is just an incredible amount of frustration by people that they don't want to have to go around the block to get to where they're going, and it really needs to be a somewhat of a priority for the city. We have had a spree of burglaries in Bailey's Grove. Luckily, the culprit was apprehended. But as I go out and talk to constituents also, there's consistency in the fact that there's several streets around the city that have crime issues that people are very concerned with their safety and don't really let their kids go out and play and intersections where cars are constantly blowing through them by parks there are definitely things where we have room for improvement.
I'll ask this question of you again, Mr. Webb. How well do you work as a team? And can you give an example of a highlight of a team accomplishment that you were part of?
Well, I find that as long as everybody has an open mind and is willing to listen to everybody's opinion, then any team can work well. I work with my PTA at my school, and we were able to organize the most successful carnival at our school ever. We had many more events than we ever had at it. I worked with setting up the raffle and selling t-shirts and organizing most of the donations. But as a team, we all work together. We'd sit down in our meetings. We would all share our concerns and opinions. And the one thing we require everybody is to hear out what everybody has to say, and listen to it, because the more people have to say, the more information you have, the better result you can have in the end. If everybody's closed-minded and thinks they already have the right answer, then you cannot get to where you're going. It's worked out really well for us. We worked together really well as a team, and we were very proud of our accomplishment. As small as it may be compared to a city, it was a great, great moment for us and for the kids of our schools.
Thank you. Mr. Redman, how well do you work as a team? And can you give an example of a highlight of a team accomplishment you were a part of?
I think I have a proven track record of working very well as a team. One of the things I do with Michigan Department of Transportation is that we bring a bunch of us together as experts and do environmental impact statements for huge transportation projects. We're about to open a new road in Ottawa County, M-231, with a 4,000-foot bridge over the Grand River. I work with a number of experts in getting the environmental document cleared for that, from traffic engineers, safety engineers, archaeologists, historians. all part of that team. We all bring our own expertise, and we put together a document that is approved by the federal government that allows that project to move forward. So within that realm, I have a lot of experience and have a lot of success, and I'm real familiar with working on a team. Beyond that, the one thing I would say here at Kentwood, and what I've been able to do on both the Parks and Rec and on the Planning Commission, is recognize the different areas of expertise that people have and learn from them. The Parks and Rec Board is made up of people from the city, from citizens from the city, and people from both Kelloggsville and Kentwood Public Schools. We're able to come to agreement, put together parks master plans, hold public hearings, and work together and come to decisions. So I have that history, and it's something that I think I do well, and I think it benefits me here on the City Commission.
Thank you. Mr. Redmond, what keeps you awake at night?
Well, our new puppy. But beyond that, your question related to the city, I don't think anything keeps me up at night, but there are things that I'd like to see happen. I was on the committee with the major investment transit study that turned out to be the bus rapid transit, that turned out to be the Silver Line. I was part of that study group back to 2002 until we opened the Silver Line in 2014. One of the things I kept hearing is how these BRTs go into cities and they bring about economic development along a division corridor. Well, I want to see it. Now, I understand that this takes time sometimes for these kind of development to occur, but I want to see, it doesn't keep me up at night, but I really hope for that division corridor. There is, on a planning commission, we approved this old rundown gas station, and they put in a new gas station. Now, that's not the best use for division, but it certainly was an improvement, looks a lot better. That corridor does, I want to see something happen there. I want to see something really take off, because I think division downtown towards Grand Rapids used to be real run down. You've seen a lot of development happening there. I want to see the same thing happen here in Kentwood.
Mr. Webb, what keeps you up at night?
Well, my mother's oxygen machine most of the time. No, I find that my passion for problem solving usually keeps me up at night, because I work through the day and I look through packets for the commission meetings, and I looking at what issues they have up, and I sit there and I take notes, I research, and I look up everything I can to try and look through and find answers, and then contact commissioners and share with them my opinions on what possible resolutions are, and discuss with them back and forth, and hope that that what I have said shed some light or helps along with the decision process. I'm very passionate and very concerned with how things go and where the end result is. I don't give up unless I can be rationalized by somebody else's thoughts. As I said, I really enjoy having everybody share their opinion openly and work together. If you only have a voice going out and nothing coming back, there's not a whole lot you can get out of finding a resolution. You end up running yourself in circles. And working together and discussing things thoroughly, is why I work many hours at night on my computer trying to find answers for what I find are problems.
Thank you. Next question, and then I'm going to go to some of the questions that were brought to me and also some follow-up questions. Do you believe that the legacy costs for the city of Kentwood are being handled efficiently?
Yes, I do. The last briefing we got on that, we're about 94% funded for those costs right now. Because of that high rate of coverage of those costs, it means we do not have to get as much interest down the road. If we, with that kind of coverage, as people start to retire, as our investments start to move forward, the amount of money we have to use from the general fund to pay pension costs reduces substantially 10, 15 years out. there's no more pension, people being added to the pension system because it's all defined contribution now. Mm-hmm. So the costs are being taken care of. And we, in our bond rating from the firms that Standard Fitch, I think the name is, we can look that up. But anyway, one of the things, you know, they did mention is that with that kind of coverage, it allows your long-term cost to be reasonably addressed, and therefore it's not a problem. So at that level of investment and everything else, we're doing fine in terms of pension. It's adequately covered. People will get their pensions, and in the end, to answer your question, yeah, I think it's taken care of.
Thank you. Mr. Webb, should I repeat the question?
Sure.
Do you feel that the legacy costs for the city of Kentwood are being handled efficiently?
Well, I would like to see our legacy costs get off our books. We have the employee retirement program that is, for the most part, well-funded. The problem is that it's still in stocks and bonds and issues that are still volatile if the economy were to crash. If the economy crashes, the city needs to come up and pay the problem with that. I'd like to see us get that funded, get it off our books, have open discussions with an annuity company of some sort and see what it is they would need from us as far as funding to get it and pass it off to them so that they're responsible for paying the retirement for the employees that are still part of the retirement program. There's just too much risk with the economy. You know, America's economy is doing all right, but worldwide economies are not necessarily doing all right. And at any point, it could make our economy crash also. And if it does, there goes our assets we have in that pension. And if so, then we end up with the short end of the stick. We got to make up for it out of the city's budget. So as soon as we can get it off to another company, let them hold that money. If they end up profiting from it in the end, let them profit from it. Get it funded, get it off our books, and let it be taken care of by a company that's their profession. We're not financial advisors.
Okay, one last question, and then I'll go to the responsive questions. What is your vision for the city of Kentwood?
My vision for the city of Kentwood is some of the things I've mentioned already. Is that we continue to look for partnerships that help our city run, become more efficient, improve the quality of life. Look for, again, the Kentwood Community Foundation as a tool to create private partnerships that can help maybe our parks and recreation programs. Look for partnerships with different communities that maybe we can share some costs. We do a lot of that already, but I think it's something else we can do to make our costs more efficient. In terms of other visions I've talked about, our corridors, our transportation corridors, our main ones are so important to commerce, 28th Street, 44th, Division. If we can come through and continue to form partnerships to help build up those economic areas, and we already have with some stuff that's been mentioned already with the Dave and Buster's and that kind of thing happened along 28th Street, if we can continue to bring that kind of commerce in, make ourselves attractive, form partnerships with businesses. One of the things that I've done in the Planning Commission is work with businesses to use the flexibility of the master plan to allow businesses to come into different zones. Those kind of flexibility, using that flexibility in our input and forming partnerships is what my vision is to make the commerce of the city of Kentwood much more vital and improve the quality of life for everybody.
Thank you. Mr. Webb, your vision for the city of Kentwood.
Well, my vision for the city of Kentwood is to attempt to get the city to a point where it is trying to be a smaller government. You know, it's not that we need to get rid of services or things, but, you know, we as a government are supposed to supply our vital services, not try and provide more than that. It's just purely our vital services that get you by day to day, and outside of that it is supposed to be where, you know, regular businesses provide beyond that. You know, our businesses in Kentwood also need to be a higher priority. The majority of our commercial businesses in Kentwood are on streets that border other communities. It is very common for similar businesses to be across the street from another business just like it in the opposing community. We need to remember that most business owners have invested their entire life savings for the opportunity to succeed. I think cities often forget how much business owners have invested and how important and necessary their success is, not only to them, but to the community. I consistently hear complaints from our businesses that Kentwood is actually very restrictive and not really open for business. We need to examine our ordinances and see where we can allow businesses to be more competitive with their neighbors across the road, and also look at, you know, today's times now, there's a lot more people we call millennials. They like to grow things fresh themselves and use their land to raise animals and enjoy things that are considered against our city ordinances. Well, our ordinances are in some ways outdated.
Thank you very much. Okay, now I'd like to do something called a rapid fire, and so I'm going to ask for a 30-second response to these questions. These questions are going to be referring to things that you have stated or things that were on your material. So, if you'll bear with me. Candidate Webb, you said in the budget that we were spending money on wants versus need. Could you explain that, please, specifically?
Well, I find that there's sometimes where we buy things that are not necessarily broken to replace them because
Could you give an example, please?
An example would be we recently purchased two trucks at the DPW. We had three trucks we purchased. One of them was in the shop, one was on the road, and so I find it completely necessary to replace that one because it's, you know, inefficient to have it on the, you know, have it if you're not actually using it. The other two trucks, I didn't hear any complaints as to their productivity. I heard complaints as to, well, we can get more money at auction today versus 6 years from now.
Thank you for your response. Mr. Redman, you are wanting to be fiscally responsible and vote to reduce sewer rates by 10%. How would you do that?
I did do it.
Oh, you did do it.
I did do it. Yep.
According to that. Okay.
That was one of the hardest votes I've ever had to take.
Okay.
To reduce it. No.
Then let me give you another question, if I may. The silver line, which you mentioned,
right,
is actually losing money and not being as it was supposedly to do in creating business. Can you explain that?
Well, transit always has to be subsidized in this country to get started. All, if you looked at all transit operations without federal or state subsidy, they'd be out of business. So that's just the nature of the beast. But people still need them in our community. That's why I think in Kentwood we support them. So in as terms of why the development isn't happening, I don't know. I'm waiting because I'd really like to see it happen. That's what happened in other communities. Maybe it takes some time. It's only been going for a year.
Thank you, Mr. Webb. You mentioned that we have extravagant buildings. Could you defend that, please?
Well, as many, many citizens have told me, this library is magnificent. It's according to them, far above and beyond what we really need as a library. It is beautiful. You can't knock that at all. But it could have been made more simply and with a smaller budget. Whether or not it was paid for with bonds or loans or however the funds were, ultimately, it could have been done more cost-effectively and still produce a library.
And are you aware of the dollar per square foot of the library?
I am not aware of the dollar per square foot.
Okay.
off the top of my head.
Okay. Have you compared it then to other libraries or other cities?
I remember looking it up, and it was not, in comparison to cities that are of this size, this is a rather nice library.
Okay, thank you. Let me ask these questions, and I will give this to Mr. Redman. Do you believe that the commissioner's endorsement of Proposition 1 was the right decision?
Well, I abstained. That's the first thing I will say. I did abstain. I didn't vote for it. I think it was from this perspective. I don't think it was the best proposal. I didn't think it had a chance the day it came out. But I think there was an understanding here at the local level that you needed more revenue sharing that's been lost, and that you also needed these roads. You needed more funding for transportation costs. So it was not the best bill in the world, but it was needed. The need is there. And so I think, yes, from that perspective, yes, it was the right vote.
Okay, thank you. Mr. Webb, you stated that the legacy costs should not be put into stocks and bonds. Where else would you invest those funds?
Well, currently, you know, we have them in stocks and bonds, and currently that's working. It's not that I don't feel that they should be in stocks and bonds. It's I feel it should not be on our books. We should get together with a annuity company or a company that can handle the management of the assets and rely on them to assure that our pensioners have the money for their future. You know, there are many ways to invest that, but we're not financial advisors. We should not be making those decisions.
Thank you. Mr. Redman, if in your role as commissioner at large, if you have a difference of opinion with the mayor on a matter brought to the commission board, how would you handle this problem?
Well, there's already been issues. I don't think I've totally saw eye to eye with the mayor. I think that we have a good relationship. I would start that with a personal discussion. And talk about that and see where what the issues were, what the impacts were, see if we could come to some sort of agreement, but it would be something that would be I'd want to work out. And then at that point, it probably was something that would take action by the whole commission, so we would bring it there, discuss it at a committee of the whole, and come to a vote and have a debate and a discussion.
Thank you very much. Mr. Webb, you mentioned that bids should be provided for you. Are you aware how other cities would do this? Do other cities make bids, all their bids information available, or do they not also have to be requested?
I am unaware of how other cities do it. I'm only aware of how, you know, how people have mentioned to me how things are here. You know, I assume there are definitely cities that have that available online. But the fact is that information is already in a digital format, and to provide it online is of very little effort. We spend an incredible amount of money on IT, so I know that we have the equipment and the ability to do that. So I don't see it as a matter of if other cities do it, it's a matter of what's important for our city.
And Mr. Webb, I'll ask you, you state that we spend an incredible amount of money on IT. Could you clarify that, please?
Well, we have a large IT budget. I guess I can't give you an exact number, but it is the amount of equipment that I see purchased for IT is above what I see a lot of corporations, you know, purchase. And again, I don't see a lot of the information on the backside of why the request is and what it's going to be used for. Just see exactly the purchase order that comes through or the purchase request that comes through, and it's voted on yay or nay. So whether it's merit or not, I can't.
Thank you very much. I'm going to, at this time, allow you 3 minutes to wrap up. And in that, would you please state what qualifies you to run for city commissioner at large? And why you should be selected in this role. And I will begin with you, Mr. Redman.
Okay, thank you. I'll start my finishing statement with, again, thanking everybody for coming out tonight. Thanks the Wyoming Kentwood Chamber of Commerce for sponsoring this. Again, what I'm gonna talk about are the things that I think are important, that the qualifications that allow me to do a good job as commissioner. Experience, leadership, for Kentwood. When you sit on the boards that I have, Parks and Rec, when you've worked with people on the Arts Advisory Council to start something from scratch that now is real popular, the concert series and library. When you're on the Planning Commission and you work with other people and listen to different points of view, people from different parts of our community and everything else, and form a consensus, you get a feel for what you have to do on the City Commission. That you're going to have to listen to other people, you're going to have to listen to your fellow commissioners, you're going to have to listen to the residents, and you're going to have to do research. And you're going to have to finally find out what the impacts are of your decisions and really research those. Through all this experience that I've had in doing this, that's what I bring to the table. I think that's my main qualification. The other thing that I think that qualifies me for this is that I really believe in being fiscally responsible as a commissioner. As I said, one of the things I was able to do, because the way we're investing money, was able to vote to reduce people's sewer rates by 10%. That's a great thing to do. It's our system's becoming more efficient because of our investment. I support those kind of things. We have a high bond rating because of our financial condition, because it's in such a good place. I will continue to work to have that happen and use the experience I have to follow policies that will help us keep that high bond rating. And then one of the things that I'm not sure that I mentioned, Kentwood has one of the lowest millage rates for operating in the state of Michigan. I will work hard to make sure that we try and keep that happening. We have used debt where we needed to, but we've used it wisely. We have spent cash where we needed to on fire stations. All three fire stations were built with cash. We recently bought 2 new fire engines in the last couple of years. We use cash for those purchases. I will continue to work on those policies to keep people's millage rates low. I understand where everybody is right now. I pay taxes too. The last thing I want to do is raise taxes. So there has to be a combination of a strategy of debt, of cash, and that kind of thing to keep things financially in a good condition. And finally, the one thing I will not compromise is safety. Safety of our residents in terms of our infrastructure, our police and fire. I will work for safety as my number one goal for the community. Safety is important for our residents, and it's something that I'll support wholeheartedly.
Thank you for your 3 minutes. I will ask Mr. Webb again for 3 minutes, a wrap up, and why is it we should select you as City Commissioner at Large for Kentwood?
Well, for starters, I am not the status quo. I will demand answers for the citizens of Kentwood, and I will be an efficient steward of city resources. I want our city to spend our hard-earned tax dollars like we would spend our budget in our homes. With a full discussion by the commission, just like a husband and wife and do in their homes, not just rubber stamping. And this will help provide transparency and accountability. One of my goals is to reduce our taxes or provide more services and pay off our debt as soon as possible to save millions in interest, which would otherwise be paid. When our families need something, we save for it. And when it's an unexpected expense, we carefully watch our spending to pay off the debt that was acquired as quickly as possible, as to not prolong the unneeded interest. My goals as a Kentwood commissioner are to protect the quality of life for every citizen in Kentwood. This means to take a closer look at our ordinances and make changes that make sense. We all know that government doesn't always make sense. I want to look at very hard and find ways to improve life and reduce the nonsense. I also intend on making sure our hard-earned tax dollars are spent thoughtfully and carefully. The recently purchased trucks of the DPW is a good example. This is just one of example and how our city can save great amounts of money, which would reduce our budget and in turn lower property tax and put money back in your pockets. This past year, the entire budget wasn't even spent. 92% of the budget was actually spent citywide, which left over $2 million that, if the budgets were more strictly budgeted, would have been money that the millage rates would have been lower and that money would have been back in your pockets. I also want to make it a goal to get some sort of year-round yard waste facility, like I said, in Kentwood. I also, when I hear complaints from citizens, I don't just hear the complaints. I actually go out and I take action. I'll go down to the city and I'll ask questions and get their answers for them, since most of the time they are hardworking people that work 9 to 5 and can't come down to the city. So I'll go down and ask the appropriate people the questions, and I'll go back to them and give them the answers that they are needing. We have a very incredibly diverse community in Kentwood. My wife is actually from Romania, and the majority of our friends are from different nationalities. We need to take into consideration all these nationalities and what their beliefs and their cultures are for them. We don't always take that into consideration because we are who we are. Well, they are all part of our community, and they all deserve to have the same rights as they once did in their countries to practice their beliefs here, whether it be to get local vegetables or have a shindigs in their ways. But I also currently serve as an alternate on the Zoning Board of Appeals, and am very proud to be able to examine people's issues, and I make sure I go out of my way to research each and every one.
Gentlemen, thank you very much for your time tonight and for answering the questions and for clarifying what it is that you stand for and what you plan to do for the city of Kentwood. Now it's up to you, folks. Election is coming up, and we need to be involved. We need to be aware. We need to study those candidates and see if their walk matches their talk, and then they can earn our vote. If you don't vote, please don't complain about the city of Kentwood or any of your governments for that matter. But I would like to appreciate you. I'd like to thank Ron Musich here in the front, who was timing us and keeping us on track. So also for Kentwood Library, of course, WKTV, our shining stars that they are, because they're always there keeping you informed on the community. And with that, we will encourage you, I do have to put in this plug, government matters. Once a month, we are at Kentwood City Hall or Wyoming City Hall, and we have all levels of government there to address your concerns. So these gentlemen are approachable, as are our other government officials. So please join us the second Monday of every month at City Hall, whether it's Kentwood or Wyoming. And with that, we will wish you a good evening.